Studio template in the mix. There's a couple of tricks and that I've added to it that came from Busy Work Beats as well as Mr. Difference. Let's get started. 12 steps of FL Studio. First is your mixer and your pre-master. In your current, I left you notes on everything in here. So from 1 to 6, you can scroll through and read everything about this template. Plus, I'm gonna explain it to you. So like I said, step 1 is your master and your pre-master. If you have been using FL Studio and you've been using it without a pre-master, you've been routing your FL Studio incorrectly. In your master, we have your visuals, which is your meter, which I have hidden in the background, so it's out of your way. Same thing with your vectorscope and your oscilloscope. Is all those two are all out of the way, so you know you don't have to worry about them being there, or you being able to move them. You have your spectrum analyzer and you have your aptitude analyzer and a safety limiter. That's just for volume control as you work through your pre-master, which is, has a clipper. You have a limiter. You have a mix EQ, mix bus EQ, and you have a mix bus compressor. And you have a Fruity Parametric EQ. Next thing you need to know is your phantom channel. Inside your phantom channel, you have on your 808, as well as your sub bass. But I have a ducking limiter. So whenever an 808 is running through here, it is at a proper tone and not one that is overbearing. So bear in mind that when it comes to that, don't deactivate this down here. And I'll show you why later, because you're going to have to follow these steps right there. You're gonna do that all over again, because once you realize you don't hear no sound, is the reason why I'm advising not to touch anything other than the fact to add your own VSTs as far as your limiters and stuff like that. You can change. I'm just giving this out to those who use FL Studio with stock plugins. All right, now you have two sections. Three would be your instrumental section. Your instrumental section is designed for the purpose of having your instrumentals up here. So say if you had a song that you or instrumental that you was doing, and let's see. And then you could just add the track right there. So it will be nothing to really add that track right here. You know what I'm saying? And then you can go ahead and record in this FL Studio template at the same time. So that's why the instrumentals are there. Then you have a drum loop. Your drum loop is designed for two things, and I have a trick on this drum loop. This is a trick that had came from, I believe, Mr. Different, where you take your Fruity Love filter. What you want to do is go to the preset, or I already have it set on here, is your simple triangle high pass low and then what you do is, what I did was I triggered it from here to a controller, which only trigger it when it turns on. I did that so that way whenever you want to add an effect to your drum pattern, you don't have to worry about it, you know, doing it separately. You could do it all in one. You could still have your drum kit go through the normal pre-master if you wanted to, or have it set like this. When you get this FL Studio, or when you download it, it will look like this. It will just be connected to the pre-master. For the purpose of this video, I'm going to show you why I did that. Like I said, on the Fruity Love filter, there's on the drum submix and loop, there's a Fruity Love filter. And if I was to go through this beat, because the Fruity Love filter is down here, when you go through this beat, you will realize in this section that the drum pattern will change. It will sound like it's underwater. So let's just start from, right here. Hold on, that sounds horrible. Let me change the audio on this. All right, let's try that again. Change the drum pattern. It went from hitting right here, and you can change it anywhere you want. Even if you didn't want it there, you wanted to say at the beginning, say you wanted it here. I designed it so you can, all it does is trigger off and on. So in here, it'll just trigger off. Point, if you are not doing any tricks to your drum kick, and your drum kick is automatically to your pre-master as well. Next section, number four, will be your drum group, your kick group. You have your 808, you have your kick, and you have a sub kick, and they're connected to a pre-kick sub master. Let me blow that up. This pre-kick submaster has a 0.5 millisecond delay. I give you that back through this transient kick, and it goes through your kick submix, which right now is connected to your drum loop for that purpose of me showing you that trick. Normally it will be here. Same thing with your claps and snares. Normally they will be here. And the same thing with your percussions. Normally they wouldn't be there. They will be here. So when you get your FL Studio, that's how it would look. When you're ready to do that trick that I showed you, all you got to do is click it off of this one and then click it onto that one. That's all you got to do. I made it so easy that everything is already set up for you. All right. Now, the reason why this transient kick is here is because I found out from a real producer as the reason why nobody was answering me back, or as far as my music was concerned, that I had good concepts, but they couldn't hear them. And that's because of this. Now, whenever I need this to go through, you bring the transient up until it matches the sound of the kick. You don't want to overpower because of the clip. That's what it'll sound like. So what you want to do is just bring it to the level of the kick itself without it clipping. Now what that will do is it'll allow your kick to translate through small devices like cell phones, iPads, or whatever type of pad you're using. and through your car stereo. I didn't know that until I got hooked up with that little trick right there. Plus, all my kicks are in mono. The key to mixing your kicks is to do everything in mono. So that's why they're in mono. The same thing with the bass. Everything is in mono when it comes to the sub bass. On to the claps. You have your claps and snares, and you have your sub mix, which would pretty much be number six, group number six. Group number seven is your percussion. So I got all your percussions, you know, here. And your VST. Your VST is here for the purpose of anyone who has Omnisphere or Contact that has multiple channel. I'll show you what I'm talking about. If you like me and I tried and you tried to keep up with game from Busy Work Beats, oh yeah, you ended up getting this. So in Omnisphere, you have to just link your input port to one, and then in the processing section, you just link this to one. You'll link this to one, and then you hit auto mapping, and then it'll link all the way down to number eight. Now, what you'll have to do is you'll have to grab a MIDI out, and you would have to link it to channel one, port one, and then you copy. When you copy that, you link the next channel to two. You don't have to do nothing to the port. All you have to do is no change the channel, and you do that so forth and so on all the way down until you get down to number eight. What will happen is in Omnisphere, you'll be able to link to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, so forth and so on by just going into here, into your multi, and then changing the out. Leave this one alone to at A, and then go to the next one, will be at A2, but you have to change it to B, the next one to C, the next one to D, the next one to E, the next one to F, G, and H. And that will link you to all of your MIDIs, and therefore you can use one VST to get all your sounds to your song. If you was even using Contact, and it would all come from out of Omnisphere. There go one. There go four, five. Six. And they're all coming out of these MIDIs. The only reason why you skip three is because on the palette, and you'll have this, you won't have Omnisphere obviously when you download this, so you'll have to link Omnisphere or Contact just the way I showed you. You have to link it to these MIDI outs. And you can go to YouTube videos that, you know, that'll show you that. But after that, we have your sub. You know, all of your subs, your leads, all that stuff is connected to its own synth. Your sub bass and your synth bass is connected to its own sub mix. And then you have vocals where you can record, you know, your artist all in one section. I have in vocals, your record automatically goes to your vocals. This trick was brought to you by In The Mix. This is how I got this little, you know, trick that I added on to this template. Was from this guy In The Mix. You can find him on YouTube too. Well, in this recording section, I have the record automatically going to the vocals, which are automatically sidechained and linked to their proper places. It's the vocals and the back vocals, the ad-libs are all connected to your vocal submix. And then you have your effects, your vocal effects, that I have the vocals, your background, and your ad-libs all sidechained to. Now, in order to properly synth, what you don't want to do is this right here. Sidechain it to this and use this right here as your send to get the effect into this channel. That is the improper way to get that send. And the reason why is because when you need to turn this down, you'll also turn down the effect here. So instead of doing that, what you want to do is use sends. And I have your sends already set up to where if you had the right click, you have your delay vocals, you have your plate, your hall, everything that you need right here. And then you just turn up the volume to the effect here. So that way it doesn't affect the volume here. And when you go to turn down the volume here, it doesn't affect the volume of the effect. So I hope everybody really gets that. That we've been improperly, you know, using this thing. Alright, after that you have your pink noise, white noise, you know, sections, your effect sections, they're on submix, and you can add your own stuff to this. You do not have to use this plainly as an FL Studio template for yourself. Let's see. I'll show you what mine look like. What mine looks like. And like I said, if you wanted to add it on to the template, I've got more stuff added on to mine. You know, I got pianos, I got guitar. You just do the same thing, piano, then you add like one dry, one wet, and then a sub mix. You know, guitar, one wet, one dry, sub mix. Strings, one dry, one wet, harp, submix, hits, horns, brass, all your orchestra, submix, your vox, one and two, submix, same thing. It's just that mine has more stuff because, you know, mine, you know, I've been building this one for the last 6 months, and then I decided, man, why should I keep this to myself? I can't, like, take knowledge with me if I should die, so why not give it to the people, right? And then, like in the same thing in yours, you have probably a delay, reverb. Only one you don't have is the glue room. But yeah, I gave you one in stereo and one in mono. So whenever you go to use the send to add your effect, like I said, you can just go anywhere you want. Even if I wanted to side chain this to one of these, I could. So if I wanted a little a delay in mono real quick, all I had to do is sidechain, go back to my vocals, go to my send, and then I sidechain it to a delay on the vocals, and no different one other than the one I have. Man, yeah, but that's how you properly use the send. Like I said, the FL Studio template that y'all got come fully loaded like this one. You got presets I have in here for you. And then I'll get back after I have this back surgery in June, the 22nd. I'll get back with y'all and I'll show y'all other little tricks and compression tricks that I've learned over the years that are different from the ones that you learned. Trust me, I got a nice one for you. The other thing I wanted to tell y'all in here in this submix that I did for you. I did do a different type of side chaining. And this type of side chaining, let me detach this so it stays there. Alright, inside your sub pre-kit and in your sub mix, there is a controller and there is a Fruity P controller. There's a balance and a Fruity P controller. One is in the pre-kick and the other one is in here. The reason why is I side chained that. So whenever you whenever a kick comes up, this a pump up, because what I did was I went in here, side chained it to the P controller, and then I changed this to invert, changed this to 0.8, press enter, next set. There you go. Instant side chain. As you can see, everything will be in its order. That's how you do that in the kick. The hell with it, right? I'll show y'all right now. Ain't no sense of stalling. Let me just get to a kick area real quick. Right there. Get back to our mixer here. Alright, go to the compress. This is what we're gonna do. This is how I compress. I take the ratio, go all the way up. I take the threshold, pull it all the way down. Take the attack, pull it all the way down. Now you can't hear anything but the effects in the background. Now, what I do to get the kick back, let me turn this effect off. What I do to get the kick back is just turn up the attack a little until I hear a little clip. That's distinctive. That's your sweet spot right there. Now you bring your ratio back to a 4-to-1. Bring your threshold up until you bring the kick back to life. And there you have it, a new way to compress a kick. Of course, I got other things on here like torque. You know, I could change the sound of my I could change the sound of the kick. That's good. Cause 30, I'm gonna tell you something. 30 milliseconds. When it comes to a kicks, at 30 milliseconds is around the meat of your kicks, because most kicks decline in its sound wave around 30 milliseconds. That was another thing I was taught by the, you know, brother in the, that's a producer in the industry that I can't even tell y'all this thing. That's a damn shame. He didn't want me to tell y'all, but you know, I respect that. And then I'll add a smack on to that too, so I can change the sound of this up. I can add more to it if I want to, or less to the kick, depending on what I'm feeling. But yeah, that kind of changes the sound of the kick. I've already and another thing I wanted to tell y'all, inside your FL Studio, instead of me using a Peermetric EQ, what I do is use the EQ that's already there and cut it off, and that's what I did for y'all template too. And each one of you who got download this template inside the submix, you'll notice that inside the channels that where mine isn't right now, there's a cutoff. Like in your kicks, I cut off the low end because you don't need the low end whenever you use kicks. Inside your snares, I cut off the high end. My bad, y'all. I cut off the high ends in your kick because you don't need the high ends. You can't really hear the high ends in the kick anyway. And I cut like maybe 20 hertz off the low end. You're going to cut off more anyway when you decide to mix it. So that's why I left it at maybe about like 20 to 30 hertz I cut off on the kicks. The snares, I cut off the low end and leave you the high end, because you hear more of the high end of the snares, as well as any of the other percussions. They all have their high end cut off in the EQ. So I did pretty much everything for you. All you got to do simply is go to whatever FL Studio drum kits y'all got, and you just pretty much open up your panel. And inside here, you just add your kick, you know, your clap, snare, and you just, I have everything set up so you don't have to go anywhere. You don't have to pretty much do anything other than just add the stuff. Everything is pretty much set up for you. The other thing I wanted to show y'all, like I said, when it comes to this template, don't mess with it. I'm gonna show you exactly what I'm talking about. Say this 808 right here. See how that channel's connected to that 808? If you mess with it, this would have happened. Now you can barely hear that. What you're gonna have to do is go back to the 808, go to the limiter, and you're gonna have to reconnect that. Go to the ghost channel. You're gonna have to reconnect that. Go to the limiter and then side chain it by one. That's why I said don't mess with none of the settings that I have, other than adding your own stuff to it. Like, you know, I have a sound meter. This was the secret too, y'all. I found out this was the secret to the reason why people wasn't listening to me. I didn't have my sound levels corrected. Now, when I go to mix my song, I use this WLM loud meter in order to get the correct loudness that I need for that industry sound. So yeah, that was one of the key things that I found out. Another thing I want to show y'all that y'all don't have that I do have is this ghost kick trick. Like, that ghost kick trick is funny. This is how that ghost kick trick really looks in mine, but it doesn't look like this in yours. You don't have this function. So what happens is, in this kick section, whenever I turn this beat on, notice the 808 right here. Even though I got it sidechained, I got that 808 side chain to the balance and to the controller like I showed y'all, this is another ducking trick where I can duck the sub bass or duck an 808 without actually boosting up the volume of the kick. Because what I did was, the way I set this up was, all these volumes are set at 5.8, which is a decent sound for you to be mixing at. And then what I did was, when I added that transient for you to come back, you can hear the transient kick come through small devices on top of this little ghost trick. What happens is when I turn this on, notice this right here is in ducking. I boost the ghost kick up. Notice that it's that duck. Now my kick can still come through just as hard without me having to mess with the 808 at all. What this ghost trick does is it allows me to use a blip or no sound at all, because I don't have it going out anything. All I have it doing is side chaining all the channels. So anything that's in the way of my kick will be ducked under my kick. That's another little industry trick. That's one that y'all don't have. Ones I did give you was the one inside hats, which was a trick that I learned from Busy Work Beats. Inside hats, I think inside Actually, yeah, I have to show you in yours. All right, so let's go back to that plugin. See, inside yours, you have the same ghost, but the difference is your ghost doesn't really have a ghost kick. It's the same thing. It's not connected to anything but other than here, but what it does is give you a proper level sound of your, like a proper level of compression is what it does for your 808s and your sub basses on here. That's why that's like that. So that way when the 808 or subs come in, they still come in at a proper level. That's all that is. On your hi-hats, I added this trick courtesy of Busy Work Beats. What happens when this thing is on, because right now it's off, when you want to add an effect to make your hi-hats sound as if they're going into a lo-fi, low-pass, high-pass effect, this effect that I have on here is all you have to do is just click on it. And then it'll do this. So it'll make your hats go back and forth on a high-low pass. That's courtesy of my man Game from Busy Work Beats. So yeah, other than that, like I said, on your channels, I did cut off the low ends for any of your percussions. Same thing with the kicks. I cut off I was right, 30 hertz of the low end, and I cut off most of the high end because you can't hear the high ends. And I hope y'all enjoy, man. If y'all need any help, please get back with me after probably July. I'm going into back surgery June the 22nd. So by the time y'all get this video, I'll probably already be in surgery, or I'll probably give it to you before I go into surgery. But I will definitely get back and answer any questions or comments or anything y'all might need answered as far as how this template is designed or what you have to do to use it.